Now what I gotta ship is a USDA choice Ida round, and then I trim off part here, trim off the other part over there, and I got some carrots and celery right down there, and I'm gonna go ahead and season it with some of this McCormick Broil steak seasoning. We're gonna broil this off in the oven because it's about 3 o'clock in the afternoon and the sky ain't looking too damn pretty. Matter of fact, it looking like nighttime almost out there. So I ain't gonna barbecue on the pit. We're gonna do this in the oven. Make an oven roast, beef on wick. Let me go ahead and season this up. And I'm gonna put it on top of those vegetables to hold it off the bottom of the little baking pan. And it's gonna be like a little roasting pan is what that's gonna simulate. I'm also gonna give this a little spritz of this Cajun Blast garlic sauce. This is all over here, boy. It's a garlic taste and all. We're gonna put this in the oven and do what we call a reverse sear on it. I'll explain that in a minute. We're gonna put this in the oven and reverse sear it. We're gonna put it in at about 350, and then we're gonna crank the temperature way up and put it on broil and then crisp the outside of it. And I'm gonna cook it until this little temperature probe comes up to about 100. Once it gets up to 100, that's when I'm gonna pull it, let it rest for a bit, and then crank the temperature up to 500 and stick it back in there. All right, boy. Now, and also started some corn on the cobs and a little new potatoes and some highly salted water. And I could, if I had some extra garlic, put it in there. But I ain't gonna do it. And it ain't looking too damn pretty outside. And yeah, I'm watching Bugs Bunny. It's about 3 o'clock in the afternoon. It looks like it's been raining its ass off. See how that? See up there? Raining plenty. That's why I'm doing it in the inside. All right. I got my Maverick probe up in that meat. It's at 103, 104. And we're fitting to pull it out and let it rest. And then crank the oven up to 500 degrees or 600 degrees and broil it. All right, so let's go ahead and do that. All right, boy. So we got a little bit of cornstarch in here. I'm gonna put some cold water in it. And what I'm gonna try to do is make a paste over there, boy. So what I'm gonna do is make a paste to put on the top of these rolls that I have here to make a glue to where the kosher salt and the caraway seeds are gonna stick. All right, boy. So I done made this little paste. We're gonna kind of lightly brush the top of these little rolls. How about that? All right, we're gonna take us some kosher salt and give them a sprinkle. And then we're gonna take some caraway seeds. Yum. And give them a little light sprinkle of that too. And we're gonna put these in the oven and just warm them up, basically. That's all we're gonna do. So we got that on now. We're gonna go from there. I overcooked this a little bit. And I hate mentioning that, but I did. Here's them kumwecky rolls. And there's the whole roast right down now, as you can see. Over here, boy. Pay attention. So we're going to cut this roll and layer some of this meat on here. I cut it ultra thin, paper thin. Or as thin as I could, anyway. And we got to get some horseradish sauce on there. So we got a little horseradish. Come on back on there, boy. Finished deal. Potatoes, salad, and stuff.